time now is 9:44 this Saturday morning. Tonight, right here on WDSU, you have a chance to catch the broadcast premiere of a program focused on something very special. It's about the bonds being built between young men here in our community and some grown-ups who want to make a difference in their lives. The documentary is called Close Ties, Tying on a New Tradition. Here's a sneak peek at some of the production.
Don't hold back. I mean, you know, there's a lot of questions that you guys been wanting to ask. Today, we didn't, you know, brought these guys to a place where you can get all these questions answered. So don't hold back. That's all we want you guys to do. Just tell us how you feel and tell us where you're trying to go in life. And I tell you, we're going to give you all that we can give.
Joining us live in our studio this morning to tell us more about it, we have one of the men at the center of the project, Mr. Wilbert Chill Wilson, known to many people in the city as the proprietor of Mr. Chill's Barbershop. We have him, and we also have one of the students featured in the production, Mr. Brandon Jones, who is 17 years old. Gentlemen, thanks for being here.
Thank you for having us.
Tell us what we just saw here.
Well, this is a small clip of me talking to some of the kids that we had had to come out to the tie-tying event with Close Ties. We wanted just to give the kids an opportunity to know that there are men in the community that care for them, and especially black men, mm-hmm. who sometimes, you know, they say that, you know, black men are nowhere around to pass the torch or teach the young about what's going on. And by me being a barber and one of my co-producers, Dr. Perry, being an educator, yeah. we just thought that, hey, this is a great opportunity to show kids about building, you know, to a greater success or building a career and using the building blocks. Sometimes it's scrambled in their life, so we can help put their building blocks together pretty much like a Rubik's Cube. You know, it's right. all scattered with the colors. Then, you know, sometimes a kid just can't put it together. So Dr. Perry and myself just help the kids just, you know, get all the colors together and pass the torch to them where they can make our community a strong community tomorrow and in the future.
And Brandon, you're a part of this program.
That's right.
Tell us what it's meant to you.
It's shown me that I can be better than myself, I guess.
Right.
I can go and do anything that I can do. My mentor, Edwin Buggage, he just taught me that there are more black educators out there and I won't be the only one. And he just assured me that I can do anything that I put my mind to.
What did you think about yourself beforehand?
I thought that I was just like a regular kid and I kind of just faded in the back. I felt like I was going to do whatever I could do, but I never motivated myself to do more. But after the program, I felt like the sky's the limit.
This is mentoring here. This is changing lives. How many young men does this program entail?
Now to date, we've had 30 young kids come through. We have 60 young men to come through.
60
we do 20,
young men.
20 boys at a time with 20 males at a time, and we pair them off, males to mentee. And, you know, each male, we pair it off with a kid, and it's so dynamic because them two get to talk to each other privately about things that they may not discuss with their teacher, their parents, their pastors at church, but these mentors be able to tell them the things that they went through in their life to get to where they're at, and these kids actually to believe these guys, and these guys are believing and helping
right.
to pinpoint, you know, what is the problem, why these black males can't get to where we want them at out here in our community. But now these males have an opportunity, these young males have an opportunity to now take what they're learning at this tie-tying event and take it out into their community and show others, like, this is possible.
Tell me about the tie. I love the fact that it's called Close Ties, Tying on a New Tradition. Why a tie? What's the significance of the tie?
Well, you look at the average kid that walks the street today and you look at the outfits they have on and you ask yourself, like, okay, this is a problem right here. Starting with the way they dress. We can't get them in a business or interview with the pants hanging down or the T-shirts or shirts that's not appropriate for jobs. So if we put a tie on you, not only you can get a job, you can be a representation of your family, your representation of your community, and it can help you get to a boardroom.
Wow.
Well, one day you might be able to take that tie off and tell other people why you should wear a tie.
Brandon, where do you see yourself in 5 years?
I'd like to be an orthodontist, and I guess wearing a tie... Oh, well, my orthodontist right now wears a tie, so that represents professionalism to me. So I think if I wear a tie, that just makes me feel, I guess, on top of the world. Like, I feel better than anyone else, per se.
And I believe you will be an orthodontist, and you have great mentors in your life. I can't thank you enough for coming on our program and sharing this wonderful documentary with us. Once again, it is called Close Ties, Tying on a New Tradition. It airs tonight at 6 p.m. right here on WDSU. There will be an encore presentation tomorrow night after our Saints on 6 postgame special, which allows the Saints and the Colts. It follows the Saints and the Colts Sunday night football. Thank you again, Wilbert Chill Wilson, for being a part of our program, and also Brandon Jones. You have something you want to say real quick?
We want to thank Jamal Woods. He's a great documentarian, and he really did his thing with Park Triangle, really made Close Ties come all together with Tying a New Tradition.
Wonderful. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks for being here. Thank you.